Well, tell me more about this light you see around you. Did you get a sense of why they're here? So one light or more?
One significant light, but there's aware that there's others in the background.
There's one significant light. Mm-hmm. Tell me more about this significant light.
She's full of love and compassion. And she's letting me know it's okay.
She's letting you know it's okay.
Mm-hmm. It's okay to leave.
Mm-hmm. It's okay to leave. And what happens next?
So we're heading towards a very bright light. It's like a gateway between this physical world and this.
You're heading towards a bright light in this gateway. Can you describe what you're experiencing in more detail?
It's just like a drifting, like I'm drifting towards the pole of this light.
You get a sense that the planet is behind you, in front of you.
It's almost a gateway within a room. I haven't kind of moved a physical distance away from the planet, but I'm just moving into a different dimension.
Is there anything being communicated to you at this time?
No, but I'm starting to feel more at peace. I'm starting to let go of the emotions.
Trying to feel more peace and let it go.
And just allowing myself to be absorbed into the light.
Tell me more about the feeling of letting go and being absorbed. And just allowing yourself to go into the light.
It's like I can see the bigger picture now. I feel like I'm back home.
So you feel like you're back home. You can see the bigger picture. Can you describe what you're experiencing in this home in more detail?
I suddenly feel wisdom. I feel like I've become, I want to use the word elder, but I don't know what that means. This is a community of beings around me, but it's light beings, it's not, we don't have physical bodies.
Do these beings around you that don't have physical bodies, do they represent themselves as a colour or a shape, or how are they communicating to you?
Yes, it's as if we have a physical form, but we don't have a physical form. It's very hard to explain. It's like I feel like I'm in a long brown tunic, but yet I know that tunic is only how I'm choosing to manifest myself. I'm just a light being, and so you can communicate through thought. You can touch each other, but it's like bright light, touching a bright light. It's not a physical touch.
Is there any significance in the touch?
Touch can be healing. If somebody is still processing things from their lifetime, a touch can give them knowledge, and a touch can give them peace and allow parts of their soul that have almost splintered off just to come back to them.
Is there anyone with you at this time, or are you alone?
I'm never alone at PM. There's always a community of souls around us.
Tell me more about this community of souls, right? Do they seem familiar to you in any way?
Yes, we're all interconnected, and it's almost like we're a cluster of souls. We're a unit of souls that just travel in time together. We know each other so well, and we are there for each other on our spiritual paths or our paths of learning.
It's cluster of souls around you? Do they seem, do they look familiar or seem familiar in any way? Do they represent or have a colour in any way?
I know they're familiar. I know I've been with them forever. I don't have faces. There's like a sense of gender, like I can feel that some of them prefer to be female, some prefer to be male. But they can be either.
And are you representing yourself as any particular gender?
I feel male. I feel male.
Just staying with this experience, what else can you describe or experience around you?
There's a sense that I'm an elder and that I'm just helping younger souls to work through what's happened to them.
You're an elder and you're helping the other souls work through. Can you tell me more about this work you do?
It feels like it's my job to... There's something about the healing touch. It's like my job to bring them back to wholeness. To try and ease the pain and the suffering that they bring from the physical realm with them.
You mentioned this community of yours. Does everyone have the same role or is it a different role?
Some use words and communication to help people talk through what's happened to them. Some are recording. It's like they're recording the records, the knowledge. Some of them are like, it's almost like the directors are planning the next stage. Definitely my job to do the healing, and it's through touches of light, and sometimes that light is green, and sometimes when I touch them the light is orange or whatever colour it is that their soul needs.
How are you aware of what colour the soul needs? How does that information come to you?
I see a wound in the soul. And I touch whatever that wound is. If that wound is guilt, so it needs green. And if that wound is emotional hurt, I'm using pink. And if that wound is an abuse of power, I'm using gold.
Can you explain a little bit more about this gold properties of the gold?
So with the abuse of power, when they come through, whether it's they've given their power away or they've abused their power over the souls, the soul comes in and it has like a murkiness, and it can be some parts of the body that it's come through in the soul. So say the murkiness is sat to the right of the ribcage. As the soul being comes in, I can see the murkiness in the soul. In that area, and I touch with the golden light.
And as you touch with this golden light, that will help heal the murkiness.
Yes, it takes away the human pain that's lodged in there. It doesn't say always take everything away, sometimes there's scars left. It takes the majority of it away and it fills it with the light that they need. And then the murkiness becomes part of their record. I don't know, somehow it's transmitted to the record keys. And it becomes part of their soul record.
It becomes part of the soul record. And does everyone go through this process? Or is it only for some people? Some souls? Does every soul?
It feels like every soul goes through this, yes, but I'm only responsible for those souls that are part of my soul group.
Tell me more about this soul group you mentioned. You're responsible for people in your own soul group. How many people are in your soul group?
I don't know the numbers, but it feels like hundreds.
Mm-hmm.
other than, yeah, it's kind of in the hundreds.
How would you recognise your soul group?
In physical form, it would just be a comfort, a comfortableness. You meet someone and you feel comfortable with them.
And the soul group, is there any similar colour, form as a soul?
We're all on paths of light. When we incarnate, we're here to try and lift the light. Lift the rest of the human race into the light.
So this role, is this the role of your soul group? Is this a common role?
Yeah.
Is the common goal of the soul group to lift the light?
It's trying to bring up the energy vibrations, so to a lot of the planets still in quite a dense energy vibration, or a dense soul incarnation, and we're here to try and lift the vibration so that everybody can begin to move more towards spirituality and less towards the earthy pursuits, I suppose is the word I want to use. The earthly concerns of power and greed and money and control.
These, the soul group, do they incarnate or do they stay as souls?
In my soul group, we have to incarnate because we can't work unless we incarnate on the earth plane. We have to incarnate to be able to help everybody around us.
What do you experience being with them again?
A sense of belonging and a sense of peace and purpose and completeness.
If you look at their core, is there anything within the core that identifies everyone together, or is it different?
It's heart energy. The energy when we incarnate, the energy we bring is very heart orientated, so it's an openness and a lovingness and a will to help others.
Is there any other goals or purpose to the soul group?
We tend to choose difficult lives, not necessarily hardship as in a physical sense, as in poverty or famine, or difficult enough lives for us to experience, I don't know the number, many. Going back to very ancient times. We seem to stay, well, I know I stay on the earth realm. Though I have a feeling I've been in water at some point. Yeah, many lives.
Do any members of your group spend extended periods away pursuing other activities?
Yes, I can feel people travelling to star nations because they need to feel a different energy. I don't feel the need to go anywhere else. Some people want to feel the energy of a different, I want to use the word labyrinth, I don't know why, a different labyrinth. A different reality, a different realm. But they're always connected to us, so I'm seeing like a shooting star. They're away, but there's a trail behind them so they can always find their way back.
Are you working with any other cell groups at this time?
I can feel that we're all interconnected, so whatever we do within our cell group has a benefit for other cell groups. This is not a specific task that we need to do.
Imagine a queen would help heal, for example, guilt and pain. Is it the same color for each soul, or does each soul respond to a different color?
Each soul will have a different vibration, so the colors are generally there for each of the emotions. But sometimes there'll be layers, so sometimes behind the guilt, there will be a hurt, there will be an emotional hurt, so sometimes you take the green and then behind there's a pink that needs healing. And maybe then behind the pink there's something else there. So that some people can just have one, but other people can have multiple layers. Because one emotion can get to pass to another emotion, to another emotion.
You mentioned that sometimes it leaves a scar. Tell me more about that.
It's like an interruption in the energy field. Sometimes if a hurt is so deep, I can take out the emotion and I can heal it with the light. It's just a little kink, a little patch of darkness in the soul that can't be healed. It just remains there and it becomes part of their character, part of their being. And people can bring this through into the next life.
How would this part of them, this scar, represent in their next life? Would it represent as an emotion, a physical? How would it represent?
Sometimes it depends. Sometimes it can be a feeling that they bring in, so it can be a lack of self-worth, or it can be a fear, it can be a physical, it can come as a physical disfigurement, it can come...
Tell me more about this rose and Aldrin. How old is your soul?
I'm as old as the earth has been here. I don't know how old that is. At the beginning I had a fast growth. From being more earthbound towards being lightbound. I think there was a life that propelled me forward and propelled me from worries about survival into wanting to worry about others or wanting to care for others and help others. Just an understanding that we're all connected, so that anything I do to others, I do to myself.